being just 12 miles from the centre of London, Harrow is the perfect place to live and work, combining the peacefulness of the Greenbelt and the hustle and bustle of an active commercial centre. Over 200,000 people reside in the 19 square miles of this Greater London borough. Harrow is an ideal base for links with every part of Britain. 5 national motorway networks are within a 30-minute drive, providing fast transit routes all over the country. Harrow is also well served by buses and rail, with the mainline Harrow and Wealdstone station offering fast direct travel into London and the Midlands. Harrow on the Hill and underground stations across the borough also have direct links into the capital, as well as with Hertfordshire and Buckinghamshire. International travellers can reach Europe's busiest airport, Heathrow, in 20 minutes. Today, the borough is one of the most thriving multicultural communities in the capital. Over 30% of the population are non-white, with a further 5% hailing from Ireland. There are many active and prominent ethnic communities within the borough boundaries. The name Harrow comes from the Anglo-Saxon word for temple or sacred grove, which relates to the site of St Mary's Church on top of Harrow on the Hill. The 900-year-old church stands on one of the highest points in Middlesex and is built on a site which probably housed a Saxon church before the Norman structure was built during William the Conqueror's reign. Neighbouring St Mary's is the world-renowned Harrow School, founded by Royal Charter in 1572, where 7 Prime Ministers have been educated, including Spencer Percival, the only Prime Minister to have been assassinated, and of course Sir Winston Churchill. During term time, the school is open to the public in the afternoon, except on Wednesdays. Past the school's gate and up the steps is the old speech room gallery, which houses a collection of watercolours, oil paintings, pottery, natural history and books. Further down the hill is a charming and ancient row of cottages, now shops, dating back to the 16th century. Historic buildings can also be found in the picturesque centre of Pinner, with the many timber-framed buildings dating back to Tudor times. The Church of St John the Baptist at the top of the High Street has parts which date back to the 13th and 14th centuries. For more than 600 years, Pinner High Street has held an annual fair by virtue of a charter granted by Edward III in 1336. The fair is held in the streets and takes place on the Wednesday after the spring bank holiday. The borough of Harrow was the largest of the manors of Middlesex at the time of the Domesday Book, with Great and Little Stanmore existing as separate manors in their own right. Within the modern borough boundaries existed 3 moated manor houses. The junction of Old Church Lane and Wolverton Road was once the nucleus of Great Stanmore. Roxith Manor now lies under the council's Grange Farm estate, and the 14th century Headstone Manor, whose previous owners included successive Archbishops of Canterbury and King Henry VIII, has been awarded a £2 million grant from the National Lottery for major renovation. Other notable buildings are Grimsdyke House, named after the dyke forming the borough's northern boundary, and was the home of Sir William Gilbert, one half of the celebrated operetta-writing partnership Gilbert and Sullivan, and he lived here from 1890 until his death in 1911. East End Farm Cottage in Moss Lane, Pinner, is the oldest timber-framed building in Middlesex and dates back to the early 15th century. And also the magnificent splendour of the unique St Lawrence's Church in Cannons Park, which boasts a beautiful Baroque interior. Heritage of a more recent nature is to be found at the Royal Air Force Bentley Priory in Stanmore. It was here, the headquarters of No. 11 Group RAF Strike Command, that Sir Hugh, later Lord Dowding, controlled his forces during the pivotal Battle of Britain in 1940, when the base was the headquarters of the Royal Air Force Fighter Command. Offering a contrast to the borough's historic buildings is the modernity of Harrow Town Centre, which has recently been transformed into one of the most comprehensive shopping centres outside central London. Three linked shopping areas, St George's, St Anne's and Station Road, offer a town centre to rival Brent Cross, with parking for 3,000 vehicles. The borough's other retail centres are Pinner, South Harrow, Wealdstone and Stanmore. Harrow's transport links benefit industry and commerce, and major employers such as Kodak, GEC Marconi, Ladbrokes and First National Bank have bases here. Indeed, Kodak arrived in Wealdstone in 1891, soon after the Metropolitan Railway opened, and over a century later remains Harrow's largest private employer. There are several industrial estates in Harrow, mainly specialising in light industry and technology, and all major food retailers have outlets across the borough. Leisure pursuits are well catered for. A well-equipped arts centre providing varied arts, crafts, music and theatre programmes is located at Hatch End. It includes the 130-seat Travellers Studio Theatre and the fine 550-seat Elliott Concert Hall. An annual arts festival is held in the autumn, which is a celebration of amateur and professional arts from the local community, held in several venues. Dance, drama, poetry, music, literature, crafts and visual arts are all included, and there is also an extensive schools program. Sport is well served, particularly since the £6 million refurbishment of the Harrow Leisure Centre, which reopened in the spring of 1997. The centre is one of the largest in northwest London, attracting 1 million people a year, and features dance and keep fit studios, a climbing wall, a health and fitness suite, and two swimming pools. Facilities for track and field events, as well as other outdoor sports, are available at the Roger Bannister Sports Centre in Uxbridge Road. And there is a 10-pin bowling alley in North Harrow. There are over 50 parks and large open spaces in Harrow, and two specially designed circular countryside walks, which cover areas of particular interest, are well worth discovering. The Bentley Priory Circular Walk is 7 kilometres long and traverses some of the most attractive parts of Harrow's Green Belt, including parks and historic settlements, and takes in woodlands where you may see wild deer at play. The Pinner Grimms Dyke Circular Walk is slightly longer. Based at the Civic Centre in between Harrow and Wealdstone, the council in Harrow provides a wide range of services to the local community. The council is committed to working in partnership with local people and organisations and is continually reviewing its services to ensure they offer best value. Harrow has consistently been in the country's top 5 local education authorities for GCSE results, and it's therefore not surprising that its schools are among the most popular in the country, and the Education Authority continues to develop its schools in order to cope with demand for places. Harrow is responsible for 27,000 pupils and a further 2,200 nursery children in 68 schools, and as such has a duty to make sure that they are safe. Harrow is a pioneer in the field of school security, and many schools have closed circuit television installed. Harrow's three tertiary colleges cater for post-16 education, from traditional academic qualifications to vocational and leisure courses, and adult education is a particularly thriving area. There are 11 libraries in the borough, attracting over 1.5 million visitors a year, with over 2 million books and recordings lent out. The libraries have just been computerised to help speed up the service and for greater efficiency. Around 6,000 people benefit from the borough's social services at any given time, ranging from the delivery of 210,000 meals on wheels a year to the provision of holiday play schemes for children with disabilities. In 1997, Harrow has over 6,000 homes available for renting to tenants, which the council has a duty to maintain and improve where appropriate. The Chief Executive's Department deals with a wide range of services, from emergency planning to the reception and information desk, which deals with 130,000 personal callers and over 60,000 telephone calls a year, and is also the main tourist information centre for Northwest London. Local residents and groups are kept in touch with council business through the quarterly Harrow People, distributed free to 80,000 homes across the borough, and a monthly community news bulletin. Environmental services covers everything from the management of parks and open spaces to refuse collection. Recycling is an important part of Harrow Agenda 21, the borough's environmental action plan. In the 1996-97 financial year, over 3,000 tonnes of recyclable paper was collected, along with 825 tonnes of glass and 15,000 litres of oil. These figures are set to soar following the introduction of the borough-wide Green Box Scheme, which invites residents to recycle waste on their doorstep rather than travel to the borough's recycling banks. As you can see, Harrow is an historic yet forward-thinking multicultural borough and is the perfect place to live, to work, to study, to shop, or to visit.